Morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to ask you to please start to take your seats. We're going to get the press conference underway here in just a few minutes. So please find a seat, and we will begin shortly. Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, if I could ask you to please find a seat or a place where you can view the podium, we're going to get the proceedings started here shortly. My name is Dan Yopchik, and I'm the Associate Athletic Director for Communications here at UIC, and I just want to go over a couple procedural things before we get started. So we have a couple of speakers lined up today. First, Chancellor Michael Amorides will speak and introduce our newest Director of Athletics at UIC, Mr. Garrett Classy. Following Mr. Classy's remarks, he's going to take questions from our assembled members of the media. Media members, I would just ask if you have a question to please raise your hand and get the attention of Kim, who will be over on the side with a wireless microphone for the benefit of our camera and those watching on our live stream on UICflames.com. So without any further ado, I would like to introduce you UIC Chancellor Michael Amorides.
Thank you, Dan, and good morning, ladies and gentlemen. What a great day for the Athletic Department and for the University of Illinois at Chicago. I want to thank you all for coming to joining us, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the Flames Athletic Center. And my job today is to formally introduce our new Director of Athletics for the University of Illinois at Chicago, Mr. Garrett Klassi. So let's welcome him for the first time. It's also a pleasure to welcome Garrett's family. His wife, Lindsay, is with us this morning. His parents, Larry and Zenda, Garrett's sister, Amy, and her husband, Brad, and the niece and nephew, Amber and Matthew, are here with us. I'm wondering, they're all coming from southern Wisconsin, and I'm wondering who is back there watching the houses today, because it looks like the whole family is here, and so is Lindsay's parents as well. Mike and Connie are here from California, so thank you for joining us. I would also like to thank the search committee. And I would like to thank the search committee, the people who put a significant amount of time and effort over a period of 3 months, ensuring that we landed somebody that I wanted to bring in here. And I will tell you, when I charged the search committee, my charge to them was kind of vague. I told them that what I want is somebody who is passionate about collegiate athletics and hungry for success. Now, both of these are difficult things to measure and figure it out, and both of them are necessary but not sufficient conditions. I wanted passion, I wanted desire for success, but we also needed somebody who knows how to do it. How can you develop strategy to lead into success, and how can you develop strategy to lead this institution into the future? Rex Toliver, by the way, who chaired the committee, is not in Chicago today, but it's not only him. The entire group of people did a fantastic job. And I have to tell you that looking for an AD at UIC was kind of a new thing. We haven't done it. It has been over 20 years since Jim Smith became the athletic director. And when you haven't done a top-level search like this for over 20 years, you're kind of rusty. Now, when we're talking about chancellor searches, we are pros. We're doing them every 2-3 years. We know how to do them. We do them very well. But in this particular case, we knew that we are going to have a very good and a very strong pool. We knew this because Jim Smith, who is also traveling, and he is not here with us today, served us well for 22 years as Director of Athletics. During this period, UIC saw the growth of our athletic teams through the Division I era for us and tasted success. We haven't feasted on success yet, but certainly we have tasted it. And just in this past year, three of our teams took part in the NCAA tournaments, men's soccer, baseball, and softball. And in fact, softball sent home an SEC team before they came back to Chicago. It's important also to remember that the Flames have been very strong in the classroom and they have been present in the community. A record 195 student athletes, and I see many of them back there, were on the academic honor roll this past fall, while as a group, our student athletes achieved a collective grade point average of 3.15, which is a record for them, an all-time high. 55 student athletes actually had a perfect 4.0 during the last semester. And they were there in the community, whether it was service projects, whether there was presence in schools or in the hospitals, they were there. Knowing this history and knowing the strength of the department, it became obvious that as soon as Jim announced his retirement, we would have a very competitive search. Sure enough, there was a good deal of interest and excitement nationwide in this position. Experienced athletic administrators from all over threw their hats in to be considered for the next AD of UIC. But one candidate clearly distinguished himself from the rest. And this is why you're here today, to formally welcome this candidate, by now our new athletic director, Garrett Classy, to our community. Garrett, I want to thank you for sharing our vision to create a world-class experience for our athletes and for the university. I'm confident of the passion you will bring to the Flames as we continue to reach our potential in the classroom, in the community, and of course in the fields and courts of competition. Garrett comes to us after serving as the Senior Associate Athletic Director for External Relationships at George Washington University. He had a responsibility over a number of key areas of operation, including development, corporate sponsorships, sports marketing, ticket sales, and communications, and he also had oversight over some of the key sports at GW. His fundraising alone led to the two largest donations in the history of George Washington's athletic department, and needless to say, very excited about that kind of record now that he's part of our team. Before moving to DC, Garrett spent 9 years on staff on the other side of the country at the University of Oregon, where he served as an integral member of the leadership staff, raising more than $140 million for the Oregon Athletics Legacy Fund. Garrett also made his mark in roles at the University of Alabama. Now, you know I came from an SEC school, so Alabama, yeah, okay. And Tulane University. He began his career in collegiate athletics as an undergraduate at a place that I worked as well, at the Athletic Department of the University of Wisconsin in Madison. And I worked at the Athletic Department of the University of Wisconsin in Madison as a graduate student. Garrett is an engaging and dynamic leader with a keen understanding of how to enhance the student-athlete experience and success, as well as enhancing the experience of all students on campus through athletics. As you can imagine, we're very eager to watch him put his talents to play for UIC. And I think he will create, at the same time that he takes care of the students, he will create an exciting portal through athletics for our alumni, for our students, future students, and for friends in the community to engage with the University of Illinois at Chicago. Now, I know this is what we want. I have no idea how he's going to do it, and he's going to tell you about how he plans to do it. So, in order to listen to him, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming, as our athletic director, UIC, Garrett Classy. Before he comes to the podium, we have to make sure that he's dressed appropriately. So this is UIC number one.
I like it.
Right?
Thank you.
Now, I don't know if you're going to put this over your jacket. Yeah, I think we can leave it for the time being.
Right.
Welcome, Garrett.
Thank you. Wow, what a ride this has been. Thank you everyone for coming out today. Really excited to be here. And thank you, Chancellor Almeridas, for these kind words. I'm very humbled and honored to be standing here in front of you today. I knew this was a special opportunity the first day I stepped on campus, and definitely the first time I met Chancellor Almeridas. Your vision for this university, with athletics involved, has gone unmatched to any leadership I've ever met at any university in my life. I want to thank you for entrusting me to serve this great institution, to serve these great coaches and administrators, and more importantly, serve these great, extraordinary student athletes. It's a responsibility I don't take lightly, and it's something that I've built in my entire career, and I am ready for this challenge. I promise you that every day I'll work my tail off to make this place a better institution than it was the day prior. So thank you very much. I'd also like to take this time to thank Bill Merchants and Rex Tolliver and the rest of the search committee, and as well as Daniel Parker and Grant Higgison of Parker Executive Search. The search was seamless from day one, very professionally run, and I know I'm a little biased, but I think they made the right choice. So thank you for all that. Also, in the Chancellor's office, Teresa Soto Plutz, I bugged her every single day since I've been hired, and I have her on speed dial, so hopefully she hasn't blocked my number yet, but she's been a huge help during the transition. And finally, I'd like to thank Jim Schmidt for his 36 years of service to UIC, 22 as athletic director. I really appreciate the foundation, Jim, that you've laid down for me here today. As I move into my remarks, I just want to say this is a great day to be a part of the UIC family. And yes, I do say family because I know this institution is a family and this athletic department is a family, and you're all going to be family to me. In fact, when I took the call to accept this job or receive the offer for the job, I was actually traveling in the Cinque Terre region of Italy, and I saw a 312 area code pop up on my phone. And at that time, I knew it was Chancellor Emeritus, and I was just hoping that this was not the worst vacation ever. I was hoping it was going to be the best vacation ever. And his first words to me are like, "Mr. Classy, I first must apologize to you." At that point, my heart just dropped. I'm thinking, this is going to be the worst vacation ever. But then he proceeds, he goes, "I'm sorry, I don't like bothering people on vacation, and I especially don't want to start out my relationship with your wife on the wrong foot, but I want to offer you the job at UIC." So from that day on, I knew this was a special place, a special man, and a special university, because it is about the family here. So thank you. Everyone that I've talked to since I've taken this job, whether it's been coaches, staff, student athletes, and believe it or not, while I was traveling to Italy, I met four UIC students. They have all asked one question: what can I do to help? That's pretty special right there. You don't see that every place. So I can tell right now, this is going to be a great place to work. Now I ask you to bear with me a few moments before I get in my remarks. No person in college athletics has accomplished what I have without some very special people. As I just talked about the UIC family, I first must introduce the people that have got me here today, starting with my family. My parents, Larry and Zenda Classy, in the front row. And they made the short trek down from New Glarus, Wisconsin, and no, they didn't bring any spotted cow for the reception later, but on their next trip down, I'm sure they'll have a trunk full for you all. You can expect to see them at many UIC sporting events, and I'm sure my dad every day will be wearing his UIC hat downtown with his coffee friends and on the school bus. But I want to thank you, Mom and Dad, for always teaching me the difference between right and wrong, for teaching me hard work, and letting me dream. Give me the resources to be who I am today. I love you both very much. Also with us today is my sister, Amy, her husband, Brad, my nephew, Matthew, and my niece, Amber. I have two brothers that aren't here today, brother Todd in Montana and a brother Jeff in Los Angeles. My brothers and sisters have taught me so much about life, especially being the youngest. I learned right from wrong, and they've always been my biggest fan. So thank you very much. Also here are my in-laws from California, Mike and Connie Pierce. Their son Spencer could not be here today, and her grandmother Sandy also could not be here. But thank you for always supporting me, for always loving me, and always being a strong rock to me and my wife, Lindsay. You've always had my back, and I appreciate it. And finally, last but not least, my favorite person in the whole world, the whole reason I'm here today, my wife, Lindsay. She's been my best friend, my rock, and we're a team. And believe it or not, she's the athlete in the family, and she had a little bit of time in college athletic administration too. So we are a team in everything we do. You can expect to see her around here a lot, but I love you with my whole heart, and thank you for your support. You understand this crazy business, which is crazy, but we love it. We both have a strong passion for it, and I couldn't do it without you. And really brief, not in my remarks, my best friend from Wisconsin, Tim Edge, made the trek down surprising me, and I really appreciate you being here. Thank you. And I promise I'll be brief, but now I'd like to touch over a few of the people that have been really integral in my career development. It's just a sum of people, and I know I'm going to miss some, and I apologize, and I can't name them all because I know all of you are hungry. You want to get next door to the reception here in a hurry, so I'm going to make this as quick as possible. At Tulane, I'd like to thank Vince Granito, Scott Sidwell, and Rick Dixon. At Alabama, John Gilbert, Kevin Allman, and the late coach Mal Moore. At Oregon, Bill Moose, Mike Bellotti, Pat Kilkenny, and Rob Mullins. And a special thanks to GW, to all the staff, coaches, student athletes, and supporters for supporting me the last 4 years, and most importantly, Patrick Nero. Patrick Nero taught me so much about college athletics and life. I wouldn't be standing here without his support. I'm proud to call him a mentor and a friend. And finally, there's two special people in my life that have made the most impact on my life and career combined. Two of my favorite people on earth. And the first I'd like to recognize is the late John Sheffield. John Sheffield was a ticket director at the University of Wisconsin, gave me my first start in college athletics, and was the person that really taught me the importance of the student athlete experience. He had more charisma than any person I've been around. He was a father figure, and he's done more for me to shape my career than anyone else. So thank you, John. I think about you every day. The other is a gentleman named Mike Marlowe. Mike is currently the Deputy Athletic Director at Washington State University and the person that hired me at the University of Oregon. He gave me the opportunity to fundraise for the first time, and he was a person that believed in me like no other. I could have gone to Mike and said, Mike, I want to be the water polo coach, and Oregon didn't even have water polo, and he believed in me enough that he probably would have found a way to develop the water polo program and let me do that. Mike is the best father, the best husband, the best college athletic administrator I've ever been around, and I strive to be more like him every single day. And to the rest of the people that I did not include, thank you for helping me to get to where I am today. Let's give them all a round of applause. Moving forward, I'd like to give you a brief introduction of who I am and what drew me to the University of Illinois at Chicago. As many of you know, I grew up in a small town on a dairy farm in Wisconsin. It was there where I learned the values of hard work, perseverance, and preparation. I was the youngest of four, and that's where I developed my competitive spirit, whether it was playing sports or getting seconds at the dinner table. Amy, we always fought for seconds, and it was a tough battle, so I'm as competitive as they come. My athletics career, as you already know, started at Wisconsin, and where I was able to secure a job there at the age of 19. And it was there, and don't listen to this too closely, student athletes, I probably spent more time working in the athletic department than I did going to class. But it prepared me for the next level, and I still graduated with a great degree and with a great grade point, but it was what I learned at Wisconsin that really helped me develop into who I am today. I've been able to work at a lot of diverse institutions. As Chancellor Amoritas had mentioned, I've been at large public institutions, University of Wisconsin, University of Alabama, University of Oregon. Been to small urban private institutions at Tulane and most recently at George Washington University. The one thing that's been constant at each university has been I've worked for a special person that gave me incrementally more responsibility and allowed me to go out and run the shop on my own. And when I ran that shop, each stop resulted in record revenue generation for every school. And what that means to all of you is that created more opportunities for our student athletes, and that's what I'm looking forward to do here today. As well, I've been around a lot of team success, and we're not talking just conference championships, we're talking about national championships. We're talking about national championships in community service, we're talking about championships in academic endeavors. We are going to strive for championships here, and my journey will allow me to mentor these fine student athletes, coaches, and administrators on the tough road it takes to win in everything we do. I'm a person that has a huge passion for my career. Other than my family and friends, it's the most important thing in my life. And I even have a larger passion for educating young people. I love what I do, and it's the only career I've known since I've been 19 years old. What drew me to UIC? Very easy. It's the people. The people always make the place. The first time I met with the search committee and Chancellor Amoritas, and the first time I stepped on this campus, I knew it was a special place. And then sitting down with the Chancellor and hearing his vision for university and athletics really sealed the deal for me. People are going to continue to take notice of this place within the city, within the region, nationally and globally, because that's what we plan on doing here. Athletics is going to be a key partner to enhance the brand and mission of the University of Illinois at Chicago. I want to leave you today with five key themes that we're going to work on every day here at UIC Athletics. The first is we're always going to support the educational mission. We're going to be aligned with the university, and we'll be a lockstep with our partners at campus, and we'll assist them in every way possible. Athletics is not the most important area on campus, but a lot of times it's the most visible, and we take that responsibility very seriously. Number two, probably most importantly, everything we do, the student athletes will be the center of it. I have conviction that we're going to be an athletic department supremely focused on the student athlete experience in every way. USC student athletes will live in an environment that allows them to compete athletically at the highest level, receive a world-class education, and feel the rewards of giving back to the community. And when you're done here, you're going to be prepared to change the world. You will leave UIC knowing they received the best education, competed for championships, and you are given the resources to take that next step in life. Number three, also very important, we're going to engage the city, we're going to engage the community. You'll see myself and our entire staff out in the alumni community and the city of Chicago, building meaningful relationships. The community will see an athletic department that is outwardly thinking, always looking for innovation and opportunity. Our story and our individual stories we create will be told and shared across the city, across the region, and across the nation. Our identity will be on display and celebrated with pride in a way that only those truly invested will understand. Number four, we're going to maintain our integrity at all times. We will operate with integrity and compete and win every single day by doing it the right way. We will prepare the right way, and we'll conduct our business the right way. And we'll make sure that every constituent of UIC is proud to call us their own. And number five, we're going to win. And we're going to win in everything we do. Wins and losses are important, and I'm as competitive a person as you will see. That starts with the field of competition, but we're going to win in everything else. Student-athlete initiatives, facilities, community engagement, and our goal is to win the Horizon League McCafferty Trophy for competitive excellence every single year. To accomplish this goal, our staff will have energy, passion, and desire to be the best. There will always be a plan, and we'll be prepared and focused on the process. It'll be hard work, we'll be prepared, and we'll always have a vision. I'd like to finish today with some messages to the constituents that I will serve. First and foremost, the UIC student athletes. I'm very fortunate and very lucky to be able to serve all of you. I cannot wait to connect with each and every one of you. You'll see me at your practices and games, and there's a lot of you. So if you see me in the hallway or out of practice, please come up and introduce yourself. I'm interested in you as a person, as well as a student athlete, and I want to learn more about you. Me and myself and our staff will be accessible to you at all times. And when your time at UIC is done, you'll look back having the best student athlete experience possible. To the UIC coaches and staff, I can't wait to learn from you. I can't wait to help you achieve all your dreams and goals. Together, we will create an unmatched environment for our student athletes. We're going to be aggressive, innovative, and we work together to promote the UIC brand, which will be the industry standard. We're going to work hard. We're going to challenge each other every single day. And most importantly, we're going to have a lot of fun doing it. As you'll find out, fun is very important to me, and we're going to have some fun. I have a lot of passion and a lot more energy than I do have passion, so bear with me and buckle up. You're in for an exciting ride. To the UIC community, we promise to be good partners on campus, and we're going to show you every day how athletics can enhance the mission of the university. We will be an integral part of the campus community and team with you to promote this great institution. We would love to see you at all of our events so we can show you all the great things that our student athletes are accomplishing. To the UIC student body, I can't wait to meet each and every one of you. Please invite me to all your student organizational events. I will come to all of them. And please come out and support your classmates. Each and every team will have a product that will compete hard and will be fun to watch. Our external team will create an environment where you leave going home happy and know that you went to a special event. And please walk around campus showing your school spirit. We'll give you something to be proud to support. Take some pride in this place. This is your school. Brag about it. Wear the UIC flame colors. And if I see you walking around campus with some other school gear on, you'll probably see me with a backpack, and I'm going to ask to swap out that gear with you right away. So just try me. I want you to show spirit. This is a special place, and be proud to call it to your own. To the UIC fans, donors, and alumni, we're going to work hard every day creatively telling our story of all the great things we're accomplishing at UIC. You're all part of the family, and we will welcome you back to be part of something special at any time. Help us promote this great institution and come back and support these student athletes. In return, you're going to have a special product, a supreme product to watch, and even better fan experience at all our events. To the city of Chicago, my wife and I and UIC is very honored and humbled to be part of one of the greatest cities in the world. If you want to be a part of something special, come to our events. If you want to partner with us and support these student athletes, you're going to get a great return on your investment. I can promise you that. We look forward to being part of the community, integrating into the community, and I'd love to come to your community groups, business groups, any city groups you may have to talk about the great things happening at USC. You're going to see us very active in this community, and you'll see our athletic department giving back to the community. To future UIC Flames, and especially those in the Chicago area, if you want the best student-athlete experience possible, play in front of your family and friends, UIC is the place for you. Choosing a college is not a four-year decision. It's a lifetime decision, and this will be the best decision you'll ever make in your life. To conclude, I'd like to thank everyone for coming out today. I look forward to meeting each and every one of you. We're going to make sure that every day we produce a product that makes you proud to say that you are a flame. Now it's time to roll up the sleeves and get to work. And something you're going to hear out of me a lot, it's fire up flames. Thank you very much. At this time, I take any questions if there are from any of the media members in the group.
Welcome to Chicago, Garrett.
Thank you.
You've went through the ranks as a student, through the ticket office, and all the way up the ladder. What's the biggest challenge as you now are at the top of the pyramid as you try and get this thing moving forward and keep growing?
I don't like to use the word challenge. I like the opportunity, but I think anytime the first time you're sitting in a chair, there's going to be a little bit of a learning curve. But the one thing that excites me is that I've worked for some of the best in the business, and I have a strong Rolodex of people that support me. And if there's any issues that come up, we're gonna turn those into opportunities and not challenges. I think every school, every university has their challenge, but we're gonna work hard every day to make sure that, you know, whether it's resource generation, whether it's student athlete concerns or initiatives, to make sure that we are on top of it. And we're gonna be out in front of things. NCAA is a changing environment, and I'm an athletic director that stays on top of those things, and we're gonna make sure that we're not reactive, we're gonna be proactive in all situations.
Can you take us through that moment when you got the phone call and when you found out? Were you in Chicago? Where were you in the country?
I was in Italy, of all places.
Oh, okay.
I was in Cinque Terre, Italy, and had just gotten on the phone with my wife, and I'm like, well, I think today is decision day. And within 10 minutes, believe it or not, I'm standing overlooking the ocean, took the phone call from Chancellor Emeritus, and I'll probably go back to that place a lot because it's a special place and moment in my life. I couldn't be more happy to take that phone call.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So you're at a commuter campus now. So how do you get students engaged in athletics and to match getting fired up, pun intended, about the athletic program?
Absolutely. I think we need to focus on the students that are here right now and build an environment with them. And if we can get them to consistently come to our events, that's going to make the other students want to stay on campus. We're going to give the fans, the students, and the students that commute back and forth, we're going to have a reason for them to stay on campus. And we'll work hard. I don't have the plan in place right now, but I'm work hard with our external team to find a way to get them to stay and get them to come back. Because these student athletes work their tails off every day. They're part of this community. They're part of this family. They should be supporting their classmates. As you'll see, our student athletes going out to their events supporting them. So we're going to treat this as a family and make sure they're welcome at every event. And they're going to know when every event is. It's not going to be the old days where they look for a poster, you know, on the sign on their drive home. Like, you know, whether it's through technology, whether social media, whether it's through, you know, an app pushing them text notifications, they're going to know when their events are, and they're going to know everything about this athletic department.
When's the football program starting?
No football program. We're going to concentrate on our 20 great teams here, and we're going to be the best of who we are and what we have.
Let me repeat this. No football program.
Yeah. Thank you. We have two great football programs. It's men's and women's soccer, so you got to come out and support them.
Former alumni, when you see the former players and all the current students and you look around this room, I imagine this journey will be one that you'll hope it grows and more people keep coming around. How will you grow the fan base? What's the first task in growing the fan base and making it more massive?
You know, one of the greatest statistics I saw when I was studying for the job interview was that one of every 10 college graduate in the city of Chicago is a UIC grad. And we have an advantage that other schools don't have. We have a strong support base right here, and we need to grow that. And so, as I mentioned in my remarks, we're going to be in the community. And as we talked about keeping the students on campus, they're going to know when our events are, and we got to get them in the building. And when they get in the building, they're going to have a fan experience like no other. We're going to do some unique, innovative things. We're going to be creative. We're going to think outside the box. And we'll probably fail on a few of those things, but we're going to learn from those mistakes and keep improving. And so really the key is to make sure you got to get them in your building for the first time. And once they're there, you got to keep communicating with them and make sure they have a good time when they're there. All right. Thank you, everyone.
So at this point, I'd like to invite everyone over to the other side of the gymnasium where we'll have a welcome reception and Garrett can get to know a lot of friendly faces in this room. So thank you for coming and we'll see you on the other side of the gym.
Well done. Well done. Thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity. I'm ready to get to work.
It's wonderful. It's wonderful. I know. And, you know, don't worry that much about this.